Hello, welcome back to the channel. This video is about how to withdraw sample copy textbooks in a school library. As I explained in a previous video, how a school library generally has a large number of sample copy textbooks in the collection. In this video, we will explore how to take sample copy textbooks out of the school library system. This is a guide to sample copy textbook withdrawal. So one of the most important chores to keep the collection current, relevant and in good shape is to remove sample copy textbooks from the school library system. To make place for new material, this procedure, also referred to as weeding, involves eliminating out-of-date, damaged or less used textbooks. Maintaining a balanced and useful library collection needs careful consideration of many aspects for effective withdrawal. Considerations for sample copy textbook withdrawal. The currency and relevance. Relevance and currency of the sample copy textbooks are two of the main things to think about. Fast changes in educational content mean that out-of-date textbook may provide less or ineffective material. Whether the material in the textbook still applies to the current curriculum and learning objectives should be taken into consideration. If you get sample copy textbooks every year, then you could replace the old editions with more recent editions. In any case, you may not stock old, outdated textbooks. This will guarantee that students and teachers have access the most current and helpful material. Next is structure. Still another important consideration is the physical state of the textbook. Heavily damaged textbooks, particularly those with missing pages, severe wear and tear or irreversible binding problems should be withdrawn. The general value of the library collection can diminish by these damaged volumes. If the textbook is valuable, rare and out of print, then consider repairing it and you might consider limiting its use to subject teachers. Evaluating each textbook's physical condition contributes to keeping a collection both useful and aesthetically pleasing. Next is circulation and statistics. Consider the usage and circulation statistics, which can reveal important information about which books are no longer in demand. Books that haven't been checked out or used in a long time. Librarians can find such books and eliminate underused resources to make place for items that better serve the requirement of teachers and students by concentrating on the circulation data. Next is the curriculum alignment. It is imperative to ensure sample copy textbooks correspond with the current curriculum in order to ascertain if the textbooks support the educational goals and objectives. Librarians should coordinate with the teachers and read the curriculum literature. To keep the library collection useful, replace books that are no longer relevant to the curriculum. Next is repeat or duplicate copies. Many times libraries have several versions of the same textbooks, particularly when different publishers supply sample copies. The need of maintaining several copies should be carefully considered, particularly if they are not in great demand. By eliminating duplicates, students and teachers may find the material they need more easily and valuable shelf space can be released. Next is consider the space. Space is a limited resource in the library. Therefore, physical space in the library must be managed well. Removing worn-out, damaged or seldom-used sample copy textbooks might provide room for new purchases. This guarantees that the library will always be a vibrant, up-to-date resource center that changes to suit the demands of its patrons. Instructions for withdrawing sample copy textbooks. First is assessment and review. Start by carefully evaluating the library's sample copy textbooks. Examine whether they are current, relevant, what is their physical state, what are the usage figures, compatibility with curriculum, and redundancy of each textbook. Next is maintenance of records. Retain the precise documentation of every textbook that is withdrawn. This involves recording the reason for withdrawal, including out-of-date material, physical damage, or low utilization of the textbook. Maintaining thorough records facilitates accountability and transparency. If you have computerized database in a library software, then make sure the withdrawal updates are done in the database. Moreover, ensure that the withdrawn copies are stamped as withdrawn. Repurposing or disposing. Choose how to dispose of or reuse removed textbooks. Among your options are selling damaged textbooks to generate money for fresh purchases, donating them to other educational institutions or neighboring associations. Check that any disposal techniques adhere to laws and school policies. Next is catalog updates. Update the library catalog to reflect the modifications after removing the textbook. To avoid misunderstanding and guarantee that the catalog fairly depicts the resources that are available, delete the records of the removed books. Information. Give teachers, students, and other library patrons information regarding the withdrawal procedure and its rationale. Good communication guarantees that everyone is aware of the advantages of keeping a current and relevant library collection and helps to control expectations. The withdrawal of sample copy textbooks is a required and advantageous procedure. The procedure calls for careful evaluation of a number of aspects. Librarians may guarantee that their collection stays useful and current by assessing relevance, physical state, usage statistics, curriculum alignment, and space limitations. By use of methodical evaluation, documentation, and open communication, the library can keep offering excellent materials that meet the needs of both teachers and students. Hope you liked the video. I have shared an article link in the description box below. Read that article also. Like, share, and subscribe to this channel. Bye until the next video.